Chosen Philippians 4, verse 4 through 7 as our scripture lessons for this evening. This is my interpretation of it in the form of a poem. God's peace. As students of the Bible, we're taught that every day should begin with praise to God for showing us the way, to thank him for the blessings that he showers on each one, and ask him for his guidance for the work that must be done. He tells us not to worry, that he has it in control. But learning to release things makes us dig deep in our soul. We like to think that we're in control. Our egos are so large. But when things fail, we turn to God and know that he's in charge. It's important to include him as you go about your day. He's your best friend, your mentor, and protector on your way. And when the day is over and you've done your very best, he sends his guardian angel to watch you while you rest. Emotions play a part in the things we say and do. Anger, hate, deceitfulness only ends up hurting you. God's plan for us is love, and then to love a little more. And for those who do his will, he'll open heaven's door. There is a calm that comes you sometimes in your life. When answers come, it's all okay, and there is no strife. You have done nothing different, but your troubles cease. This gift comes from your Father, and it's simply called God's peace.
Our scripture is from Philippians chapter 4, and I will be reading verses 4 through 9. Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put it into practice. And the God of peace will be with you. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
As I read this again, I saw it in a different way. And this is why we should always be reading our Bible. It speaks to us in different ways and fills every need. Some people read this scripture, and this is what they see. The times when God has come to them and helped them to be free. They're sitting by their loved one as they take their final breath, consumed by grief and wondering if they'll ever have some rest. The job they've poured their life into, with a goal almost attained, is taken from them suddenly, and there is so much pain. Perhaps your health is failing and your future's looking dim. You search and search for answers, but the future's looking grim. Divorce can tear your heart to shreds. You'll never be so low. The world is black with your despair. Recovery is so slow. Old age is upon you and your body's wearing out. You hate what nature's doing. That is what life's all about. But when you're at your lowest, engulfed in fear and pain, out of the blue, God sends to you this peace we can't explain. Somehow calmness fills our soul, and we know that we can complete this task before us because it is God's plan.
Thank you.
As we close our service, I would like to close it with a prayer, asking God that we be anxious for nothing, based on Philippians 4, verse 6. Lord, you have told us in your holy word to be anxious for nothing, and we know in our hearts that we are anxious about lots of things. And what is worse, we pretend to others that we are not worried, when in fact we are anxious about everything. We know that such strivings are not your will for our lives, and we pray, dear Lord, that you will show us how we may live our lives resting on your promises of peace and protection. You said in your holy word not to be anxious, but pray instead about everything and to talk to you about what we need. You told us to have thankful hearts for all that you have done in our lives. Precious Lord, we are coming to you this very moment to tell you that we long to stop being so anxious and to ask that in your grace you would keep us from all anxious thoughts and give us your peace that surpasses all understanding. We also pray that you will help us to keep our minds fixed on Jesus, so that when any anxious imaginings start to surface in our minds, we may immediately turn our thoughts unto you and thank you for all that you have done for us and for the many promises that are ours in Christ Jesus. Thank you that you are a God who listens to the cries of our hearts and who answers our prayers. In the strong and blessed name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.